Howdy YouTube folks, I'm making you another video on this, and today we're going to pull the tank off. I've tried to get the muffler. Let's see if maybe if this thing has any spark with any luck. I don't know what I'm going to get accomplished in this video, because I'm trying not to make it too long of the videos. So whatever I can get done, it's your friendly spirit wolf. Let's see what we can do. So I'm going to find a spot to set you where you can see what I'm doing. But I don't know where I can set. So let's start. It's going to be awfully close. I wish you had a tripod stand of some kind. Now let's try holding it with one hand and doing what I'm doing. Okay. Sorry. A lot better yet. Doesn't knock you over, but you can kind of see what I'm doing and adjust, and I'll show you what I'm doing as I do it. So I like the bolts and what they are. Thought it was. Unless I'll back on the bolt here. Had to go get a screwdriver. And I thought, why not bring you along for this part? These will probably get uploaded within the same day. Maybe. Depending, because they're being filmed the same day. It's just the way my algorithm works. So what you have here is this. And this is a 7/16 square nut that's holding this on. If yours has a tank like this. Again, I don't know if it's factory, but that's what mine's holding on. And then you have these brackets right here that are mounted to the holding it to the frame, the gas tank. So we'll get the other side in there. At some point I'll show you what the brackets look like for those of you who are not familiar with working on a small engine and it's new to you. I like to walk through those steps. Just because I know it can be daunting. It looks pretty straightforward, of course, but you know, it's just something I feel need to show you. Because I like to show these desk things that a lot of others do not show when working on small engines. So that's what you'll see a lot of me do. Because there are things that a lot of people who work on small engines don't show you, because they assume you would already pick it up, and most likely, like I said, you probably would. It's just me being me. So I have to take this tank off because new discovery is that it does, since the previous video before that I made on this tank, does have a hole in it, I believe, and I'm going to try to get it welded. I would like to use this tank, whether it was a stock tank or not. I think it is, but again, like I said, I could. People swap this stuff up all the time, use what they have. It's not entirely surprising when you find a mower that's been beat, and somebody's just been like, used whatever they had to fix it with, and called it good. The reason I say that is because the fact that the tank is red. Unless the tank was originally white and they painted it red because it's all it had. But you don't really see any bleed-in of any other colors on it that I can tell thus far. And the way they did this restoration, they just covered up the other paint. So that's why I'm leading to believe that maybe this was original painted red from the factory. That just had some, went to something else, possibly. But again, like I said, I don't know that to be sure. As I suspected, I don't know if you YouTube folks get well, so I'll get it all. So you guys. But it is rotten, as I thought it would be. Sitting outside, gotta figure the weather gets to it. This gas fuel line would have to be replaced anyway, since this fuel line is broke. Basically, coming apart in my hands. Basically right now, pull apart every fiber of that, of the internals of that rubber fuel line. If you can see right there, there's a whole bunch of holes. So, and it's got some heavy duty rust in it, I can tell it does. So. Weather has not fared well for this bugger. Yeah, that's rust. That is definitely rust. Shame, because it had been outside. But let's see if I can get something. I don't know if you can see that, but that's pure rust. Figured. Like I said, I'm going to try to repair this tank. I believe it possibly could be repaired, but one never knows. It's worth a shot. I don't think I'm going to be able to get this to turn over without the grease. But I thought I'd do a little bit of work on it. For now, we'll pull these. I will have to put a temp tank on it. I will show you some. I can get this off. I don't think I can. Well, I'll walk you over to it, YouTube folks. What we're looking at right here. That is. What we're looking at right here is, see that? I think I showed you that in the first video, but we'll show you it again, that key stuck in there. I'm going to try to remove that out of it, so pretty straightforward to take them off. It's one nut, I believe it's 9/16, but I used an adjustable. I could be wrong about that. I just did it the easy way and used an adjustable, which is a cheater for any mechanic. As you can see, the tank is worse for wear. Let's see what shape this spark plug is in. You guys both will see with me. And hoping nothing goes. Actually, let's dust that off first. I will be right back. Just put it back down again where he was. Hoping you can see it. vacuum these, folks. I'm going to dust around this real quick. I grab the adjustable because I am going to pull that ignition switch back out. How many guesses do you guys want to bet that there is something? Let's start with that. And I'll grab you when I do that. Because of all the stuff on that, I may have to vacuum it. But let's pull the shroud first. And I will show you guys that after. And I bet you any money that there's a family of rat nest or mice nest, whatever, and behind this shroud. I don't know if I'm going to fully be able to pull it from here or not. There's those other bolts. I may have to pull this engine. But we'll see. And we're going to learn together. I think there's going to be some sort of nest in here, telling by all the packing. This is one of the worst for wear ones I've seen so far. And I've seen some pretty rough stuff. And this one is up there with it. Like I said, I wasn't surprised when I grabbed it. Because being that it had been sitting outside, something, because they sit outside so much that over the years that things just want to live in them. And I didn't even need to go grab a sock, which is good because I was trying to avoid that. Typically I get a sock and it's a heck of a lot easier. But because I'm filming, video gets longer when I do so, but this was kind of just a spur of the moment video, what I was thinking of doing at the moment as I'm filming it, and this just came into mind. Why don't I check under the shroud, because of all the junk around the spark plug, I don't want it to go inside the engine. Like I said, this engine might have to be pulled and brought into the shop. What's wrong with this engine, if anything. I mean, it could have just been drained of oil when the landscaper was getting ready to scrap some of the stuff, but he just hadn't got to that, and I was able to buy it just in time. One never knows. Again, I'm going to say this may have been ran out of oil, but that's not a definite. Not ran out, but ran low, and then parked, because they ran it low on oil. Now, this engine could have a barrage of issues, but the tractor seems to be solid, and it seems to shift okay, except third, it kind of doesn't want to go in third. Could be the planetary sticking a little and just not. If this has planetaries on it, which I'm pretty sure it does, it could be just planetary sticking. Because he these older ones have a thing called planetaries on them, is what I've always heard them to be called as, and they're just little, like, shafts. Tend to get stuck. I'm not whole familiar with the newer stuff, so I couldn't tell you if the newer stuff has planetaries or not. Just, like I said, I'm not a real expert on the new stuff. I'm sure these points will probably be needing to go through. That's usually the case. So I'm going to try to get this off, and I figured it wouldn't come off as easy as I thought it would. Never usually do these lovely front pulleys. What I may have to do is get this starter generator loose, because I got tension on it. Just kind of hoping I didn't have to, but I probably will. This engine spins freely though, so that's a good sign. That's 1/2. Let me get a 1/2 socket and another adjustable access part here. I think I know where I get my money. Just trying to loosen this up a little bit so we can see if I can't get that belt off of there. I'm just going to leave the starter generator on there for now anyways, so that's not a big deal. Go ahead and get on this side. I mean, it's just awkward. Thank you. hasn't been off in a while, so it could be stuck some. We'll see what we can do. I just think I need to get that looser. I'm gonna do, I think, just take this, see if we can't get have to take it out. I'm not going to find this engine properly. I'll have to take it out anyway, so might as well just take it out now. The fun part right here, YouTube folks. They couldn't have made this piece of equipment have any tighter routing than this. Right here. Like I said, I'll probably have to pull this engine, so it's gonna make more sense to just take that starter generator. Thank you. not a love when you find that hidden gem of a nut. I was sad, a hunch there was something else. Belt is probably seeing better days. Eventually it's going to need a replacement. That belt has had all kind of curled, but for now we're going to try to get away with using that belt. Thank you.
good predicament. Steady pace. We'll get off. I hope the camera's still rolling because my battery will start to go. Try spinning it the other way. Keep it focused. Thank you.
having a fun time getting that off. I'm hurting in my knees from kneeling. So I think I'm going to cut this video short and film another one once I get that off. That will show you the... show you it off. And I'll show you what I'm trying to get off. So, that thing right there. There'll be another upcoming video. Stay tuned, as always. Keep your heads up. Stay strong, all that kind of jazz. Have an excellent time, whatever it is, wherever you are. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. As always, you know the drill. Sunshine, unicorns, and rainbows.